video, we're going to be exploring tangent and cotangent functions. Notice here that we have our tangent functions, and as x approaches negative radical 2, so if we go a little bit more specifically with just this piece here, that as x approaches negative radical 2, excuse me, negative pi over 2, our tangent of x approaches negative infinity. And as x approaches positive pi over 2, our tangent function approaches positive infinity. Similarly, with our cotangent function, we can see that as x approaches 0, our cotangent function approaches positive infinity. And as x approaches pi, our cotangent function approaches negative infinity. Some characteristics of our y equals the tangent of x and y equals the cotangent of x are as follows. So the functions y equals tangent of x and y equals cotangent of x, you can say that the domain of y equals the tangent of x is going to be all real numbers except odd multiples of pi over 2. At these x values, the graph has a vertical asymptote. Now, the domain of all y equals the cotangent of x is all real numbers except at multiples of pi. And at these x values, the graph has vertical asymptotes. The range of each function is all real numbers. So the functions do not have maximum or minimum values, and the graphs do not have an amplitude. The period of each graph is pi. The x-intercepts for y equals the tangent of x occur when x equals 0, plus or minus pi, plus or minus 2 pi, plus or minus 3 pi. And it's important to note that these values are the asymptotes for the cotangent. The x-intercepts for y equals the cotangent of x occur when x equals plus or minus pi over 2, plus or minus 3 pi over 2, plus or minus 5 pi over 2, plus or minus 7 pi over 2, and so on. And it's important to note that these are the asymptotes for tangent. When it comes to graphing our tangent and cotangent functions, our period and vertical asymptotes of y equals a times the tangent of bx and y equals a times the cotangent of bx, where a and b our non-zero numbers are as follows. The period of the graph of each function is going to be pi over the absolute value of b. The vertical asymptotes for y equals a times the tangent of bx are going to be the odd multiples of pi divided by 2 times the absolute value of b. This represents half a period. The vertical asymptotes for y equals a times the cotangent of bx are multiples of pi over the absolute value of b. These are the period. So how many key values does each of the graphs have? And the answer there is 5 key points. We have our asymptotes. Each representing a key value. We have our middle point and each of these points here, occurring at 1/4 of each section. So this represents 1/4 of our period for each piece. And the same goes for our cotangent. We have our asymptotes, each one representing a key piece, and then dividing into four sections, we have our remaining pieces. We have our center and our other two pieces. So again, we have five key points, each occurring at 1/4 of the period.